And welcome again to our next episode of Lockdown Made Easy with the really cool team. Today we're going to talk about language again. And last week we were talking about some ideas on how to help develop your child's oral skills. And today I'm going to present three ways by which you can help expand your toddler's vocabulary. So let's start. This might sound very silly, but the first and the most important rule to help your child to develop those language skills is simply talking. And I mean talking a lot and talking all the time. Sometimes we make that mistake and we assume that our child doesn't talk, so they don't understand us, but that's not true. So this misunderstanding just leads to a situation when the child is not exposed to enough language, and we would like to avoid that. So we should talk to our children a lot, all the time, explaining the world around them. We should use proper names of objects. We should avoid baby language, which I mean we won't say woof woof, just we say a dog. And we should use full sentences. We should speak clearly and name all the objects that describe them. So for example, instead of saying a dress, we can say a beautiful pink dress with flowers. So we're using long descriptions of everything that your child can see. This way you will expand your child's vocabulary in the best, because natural way. So let's do our little reflection on the way you talk to your toddler. And I have a little checklist for you here, ready? I'm going to upload it into our blog section on our reallycool.ie page, so you can check it later. So you can have a look, you can check if you're describing the words, the world to your toddler, if you use full sentences, if you use proper language, not baby language, if you're using descriptive words when you to expand your toddler's vocabulary. Are you teaching your toddler new words by pointing to new things? So you can print it out and stick it on your fridge even, just so you have it in your mind. And don't worry if you didn't tick all the boxes. It's never too late to start. So that was our first step. And now we're going to our step number two. Imitate sounds. So this is great for pre-language activities. And you can start this as early as you want, even during the baby stage. When your child starts making sounds, you can play sound game with them. So at first, you can repeat the sounds that your baby is making. So if your baby says ma ma, you can repeat ma ma after your baby. And then maybe you can try to make your own sound, maybe da da or ta ta or any other sounds. And maybe your child will repeat your sound as well. You can make those sounds more complicated as they grow, of course, and make it funny. You also can make different faces. For example, stick out your tongue or blow pretended bubbles. All of them activities, even though they might feel a bit funny, they help to work the oral motor skills. You can also use the mirror and let your child stick his tongue, and maybe he will notice his face in the mirror. I think it just adds some more fun into this activity as well. Another good idea is imitating animal sounds and vehicle sounds. So don't forget to tell your child the proper name of the animal as well, but still use those sounds. So if your child sees a cat and says meow meow, you can say, yes, this is a cat and it says meow. And if they say vroom vroom, you can say, yes, this is a motorbike and it makes a sound vroom vroom. Step number three, use books and flashcards. You should read to your child every day. Even this 5 or 10 minutes during the day to read the book is very important for your child. The best time is before your bedtime, but if your bedtime routine is different, that's okay. You can use any time during the day and it's great. But find those few minutes every day just to read the book to your child. It can be frustrating at first that your child doesn't show any interest and wants to hold the book only and turn the pages instead of letting you to read the words, but don't worry, it's very normal, it's usual, it's normal stage of development, so just let them do it. Maybe use the books where the pages are hard, so they can't read them so easily. Let them hold it, and while you talk to them and name the objects, they can just turn the pages for you. So that's the way of reading the book as well. You don't need to read a long story straight away. Some children will be able for it once they get a bit older, but it's important to get into the routine of reading. So remember about it, and just describe whatever you see in the book. Here I have a few examples of books you can use to develop your child's vocabulary. This book gives you lots of possibilities of talking to your child. You can talk about different colors, you can talk about different textures, different patterns, different objects and animals you see in the book. And you see, you don't really need to read the book straight away. You can just enjoy discovering different things, looking at different leaves, let's say, or animals, and try to make their sounds. So lots of fun with this little book. And there's another one. It's actually, I have a full collection of these books, and they're super because they actually have no words. And some people say maybe it's not the best that I don't have words, but I think it's great because anytime you look at the page, you see something different. So anytime you take this book, you can tell different story to your child, or maybe your child will tell the story himself. So just look at the pictures and discover page by page. And I can promise you that this book will give you loads of fun, and it will keep your child busy for a long time. Another great help for language development are flashcards. You can buy ready-made flashcards, or you can make some yourself on whatever subject you want. So I have a few flashcards here. I have my farm animals. I have a cow and a sheep and a horse and a rooster. So first you can place few flashcards on the floor, for example, and ask your child to give you a duck or to give you a cow or whatever else is on the picture. This way you will know if they understand the words, if they can recognize the animals. Then you can maybe ask them to close their eyes and put one animal away and ask them to guess which animal is missing. So it's a different variation of the same game, which helps us to develop the language. You can also play matching games. So if you have a few animals at home as well, like, you know, play animals, you can make some flashcards to match those animals and ask your child to match them. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next time.